Thank you. And I'm gonna call each person's name, and they'll come and get their diploma, and then they can go with you. And there are refreshments there, whatever. You can stay for refreshments if you don't want to leave, because this, the weather is really...
Wonderful, just wonderful.
All right, when I call your name, you come up, and you take it with your left hand and shake hands with your right hand, okay? And there is no special order here. Kimberly.
I'm sorry.
Thank you.
Betty, you done good.
Oh, nice to meet you.
Sound like a man.
That was darling. It was really cute. Oh, what patience. I admire you. You need so many covered papers.
Are you going to be at the
Yeah. It's just that I don't really feel like you have shapes to come down.
As the curtain opened to find Karen, James, Susie, Bobby, and Mary building a time machine. With hammers and nails, they are busy working on a great project. The wondrous machine is nearly completed. Kids load themselves into the time machine. The big clock spins back in time.
It is now the year 1745. It is summer in the colonial state of Virginia. George is now on the farm feeding his animals.
What is your name?
George Washington.
Oh, my.
Once again, the time machine hops, spins forward, and stops. Kids and George. Get out of the time machine and see President George standing before a group of people with a 13-colony flag.
took her first flight in California. She worked for a telephone company to pay the $1,000 needed for her flight lessons. Amelia decided on social work as a career in Boston and continued flying at a nearby airfield. After flying over the Atlantic, she decided to give up her social work. She was writing a lecture about flying. She wrote a book about the Atlantic flight and became aviation editor at Cosmopolitan magazine. She set many speed and altitude records. She was the first woman to fly from Hawaii to the United States, the first to fly across the United States alone in both directions, the first to fly nonstop from Mexico City to New York and New Jersey, and one of the first to fly an auto gear in full weather in the helicopter. Amelia's last flight was another one. She wanted to fly around the world at the equator. During the final stages of this trip, her flight disappeared in a pile of diamonds in the Pacific.
of our play. I hope you enjoyed it. Don't leave yet, though, because we need to show you somebody who was back there making all those sounds. Eric, would you like to come up? Okay. And I'd like to introduce to you the other people who worked on this play, Miss Willoughby and Mrs. Linda Stanfill. Willoughby. Stanfill is responsible for all these wonderful costumes and for all this scenery. That's her part of our production. So we thank her very much. We'll send the drama students back slowly, so will the drama students please stay here? And we want you guys to leave orderly. So let's see if we can have the kindergartners stand up.